your door. I know one thing for sure, I've never been so close before. Hey guys, how are you doing? I hope you're doing great. We're doing fine. We have some news to share this week, and they're not necessarily great news. So where do I start? I actually wanted to do this with Daniel, but we didn't find time to do it together, or I don't know, we weren't in the right mood to do it together, to talk about this, so I am finally just doing it on my own. But we wanted to share with you that we are taking a break from the adoption process. And just saying this out loud makes me feel very, I don't know, emotional, I guess. So as you know, we told you last week that that youth welfare services had suggested that we do the home study again, because our first home study had been negative. During that weekend where we had to talk about this, we just realized that we had, for the longest time now, we had been just going through the motions of the adoption process without really feeling it. We have been tired for a long time. We have been exhausted from the process itself. I think it's important for us to recognize our limits and recognize when we're close to a limit. And we just realized, having to make this decision, we just realized that the both of us were extremely dangerously close to our limits in the adoption process. And that if anything in the next phases, if anything went not according to plan, that we were probably going to say, just forget it, you know, just leave this whole plan behind us, let's move on, let's think of something else. And because adopting is so important to us, we want to do it right, we want to be excited about it, we want to be ready for our kids when they come home, we want to be able to offer them everything that they need, everything that we can give them. And right now we just know that we have so much more to offer than what we could offer right now. And it makes me really sad to say this, but we just realized it was the best decision. It was wisest if we took a break before we broke, definitely. So after we made this decision, I went to Youth Welfare Services to talk to them personally. I didn't want to inform something like this per email or phone or whatever. Thankfully, I was able to get a time to talk to her personally in a very short notice. And I went there and I had a heart-to-heart talk to her. It was very nice. I really, really like this lady who works with us in our process. And I just explained to her, basically, you know, we're just tired. We're really, really emotionally exhausted from this process and from getting one bad, you know, bad news after the other, and just, you know, things going wrong or taking longer than expected. It's just been a really stressful process and frustrating a lot of times. So we just we would like to have a break and recover emotionally from the process so that we can go forward with our hearts in it again. if that makes sense. And it was really nice. She looked at me and she said, you know what, I am not surprised by this. The last time you came here, I even told my colleagues, I think they're exhausted, I think they're really tired from this process. She also said she thought it was a very wise decision and that she understood and that we can take a break without losing anything that we did up to now. If we're ready to move forward again in 2 months, we can. We just have to call them and say, you know, let's do the home study again. If we're ready in 6 months, in a year, it could take longer than a year. We have no idea. We just don't want to think about it right now. And I thought I would feel more relieved. I've just been feeling really sad. I just don't know how to deal with this now, this information. I haven't been able to tell anybody. My parents don't know about it. I told my brother and my best friend, and that's it. And I don't want to tell people. Daniel doesn't either, because we just don't want to talk about it. When I'm frustrated with something, or when something sad happens, I tend to need some time to process things on my own before I can talk to people about them. So thank you so much for listening yet again. Thanks for understanding. Thanks for giving us time to process this. I know I'm treating this as a huge thing. Sometimes I think, like, oh, it's not even that big of a deal. It's just a break. We're not giving it up or anything. But to us, it is a really big deal, because it's the first time in 9 years where we're not trying to have kids. We're officially not doing anything about it. Just being the two of us. And it feels like a very big thing to us. So, you know, thank you for being there for us. Thanks, it means a lot. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. We talk about adoption, well, not right now. We're probably gonna talk a little less about adoption in the next few videos, but we talk about adoption and fertility and just everyday life. We do some vlogs sometimes, so if you're new to our channel, welcome. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.